So welcome back to town, the big major town. I'm here because we of course have the collect all the cards quest for Gwent, but I'm specifically curious about this one because there's a sub-objective that says obtain a basic Skellige deck. And I think that might be how you get started with the whole thing. Because I'm collecting bonus decks for the bonus cards for the deck, but there seems to be a specific implication that you can also all in one place get the entirety of Skellige. Not all of it, but, you know, something to play with. Because otherwise I'm just getting like one card at a time. It's like, look, you got a boat. Okay, cool. I guess this will just sit here and rot.
Am I too late to sign up? We've one slot free for anyone willing to play the Skellige deck.
This a face no ointment could help.
Ha 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 ha. So they must be hosting a tournament here, and you can only get in if you're willing to play as Skellige.
I assure you, Skellige is just as strong as the other factions. It shall soon be considered canon. Of this, I'm certain.
I don't know. Always been an Ilfgaard man myself. I must give it some more thought.
Geralt of Rivia saw a notice about a Gwent tournament.
By all means, you've come to the right place. I am Count Martin Monnier, Organizer-in-Chief. Our tourney's more than mere diversion. We've a mission, see? To spread word of my brother's brainchild, Skellige, a new Gwent faction.
New deck? Where'd you get the idea? I mean, why bother?
All Beauclair knows me as a great lover and promoter of Gwent. My brother, dead for some time now, was known to be the same. We shared another great passion, travel. Spent a great many years at sea in our youth, marking out our territory in multiple corners of the world. Yet the one that truly grabbed us by the stones were the Skellige Isles. The stormy sea, consumed by a fever, a suicidal awe, dashing itself against somber cliffs. That is the image I retain. It and others like it inspired my brother to devise the new faction.
These new cards, tell me something about them.
Their design embodies the Isle's spirit, the rage-filled potency, the rough, brutal beauty. Famed Skelligers, heroes of lore, berserkers and beasts ogle us from the cards. Bran Tuirsek is the faction's leader, of course.
And the other famous Skelligers?
Hjalmar and Ceres on Kreite, naturally, though not conjoined. Also Heimdall the hero, the venerable druid Ermion, the list goes on.
The tournament. Where do I sign up to play?
Right here with me. I've one slot open. But there's a condition. You must use cards of the Skellige faction. You see, I've already asked a great many seasoned players to do the same. Alas, all fear novelties, disdain process, care too much for the climax, for winning. So they insist on playing with their tried and true decks.
Long story short, you need a sucker who'll risk it. Take a stab at proving Skellige's no worse than the established decks. Best way to do that'd be to win this tournament using your brother's cards.
We understand one another perfectly, I see. Behold this trophy, standing stiff and strong. It could be yours if you win.
Not bad. Could look great in my house. On the sideboard, maybe. All right, I'll give it a shot. Play using the new faction.
That is an exceedingly good rub to my loins. Just one small adjoinder. I can only provide you a basic Skellige deck. My brother, alas, gave away or lost many key cards.
No chance I can win the tournament with these cards?
An issue easily resolved. You must simply face local Gwent competitors, win the missing cards from them. Besides, it would be very good practice for the tournament itself. Here, the cards I can spare you. Take them, please. The rest I keep for myself, for I, too, intend to play as Skellige.
That'll get us started. Let's take a look at these. So now we have the basic deck. Although which cards are specific to the deck might be a little hard to identify from here. Let's see here. There's Maridrome. We've seen this played against us before. So this is the thing that triggers transformations and all Berserker cards in the same row. Didn't want to throw that out there. It's part of the basic deck type. Those are all cards I already have. Pjalmar, level 10 hero. Not affected by any- yes, he's just a special level 10 ranged hero. Madman Lugos, level 6, noticeably weaker. Blue Boy Lugos, I'm damn near ready to puke from boredom. Wow. Endearing. Ooh, level 6 tight bond. That's a pretty good starting point for a tight bond character, especially when you get 3 of them. Those could get strong fast. The longships also have tight bond. I believe I already have one of those. Let's see, Clan Brokvar Archer. Level 6, 0 special abilities. That's the type of card that I remove from my deck first when I'm getting more interesting cards. Ooh, level 4 weapons. Characters. Holger Blackhand and Donar and Hindar. Svanrege. Udrik. There's a Berserker. Found one. Is it just one? Yep, it's just one. Clan Dorok, Armorsmith. I'll add them all for now, but I get the feeling I'll be removing a lot of these basics from the deck. Because it seems like they're never really effective. If they're low strength and have no special abilities, what's the point at that point? See, the Clan Haymade Scald. Here we got a light longship. It'll muster. Find any cards in the same deck and play them instantly. But I only have 2, so it's not a very big muster. Unless by other cards in the same deck you also mean the war longships. If playing a light longship brought in war longships from your deck, that'd be pretty insane. The Shield Maiden has tight bond, but I only have 1. Great. A medic. There we go. Birna Bran. Skellige must have a strong king, no matter what it takes. She was a nice fellow, and not horrible at all. Berserker. Once again, only level 2 strength. It's a young Berserker. They probably both transform into the same thing, though. Or so I would think. At the moment, we have 31 hero cards. Or, I mean, 31 total cards, 2 specials. Specials are just probably Skellige Storm and the Mushrooms. Yeah, Maedrum. So to get some basics in there, we probably want a couple Commander's Horn, a couple Scorches, a couple Decoys. Maybe not a lot of Weather. But that's probably a decent start. Just as a vague concept. I'll stick with that for now. We'll see what happens next time I try to play it against somebody. I don't want to tease the people that like Gwent. Let's go find one of our local opponents, and we'll try the Skellige deck against them. There should be some nearby, like right there. So, one of the results of this thing is that The objective for finding the 19 cards actually maps the locations for the other cards. I'm not about to marathon 14 consecutive Gwent matches to unlock them all, but, might as well do one right now to try out our new Skellige deck and give it a shot. Upstairs. After this, I'm probably gonna actually do more, story missions, actually. Since I think it's been like 5 or 6 episodes since the last time we did main story. Main entrance is over here. Hello, sir. Can I interest you in a game of Gwent, whoever the hell lives in here?
God, it sucks its blood to piss. I paid too much after game.
You seem like you might even have a quest for me, judging by that dialogue. Camerlengo.
Greetings, brave hero. I am Raphael de Sermann, and I am the Ducal Camerlengo.
I'm Geralt. So what is it you do here?
I pay the knight's errand.
For what?
Our knights wander the roads, protecting Toussaint from bandits and monsters. It is fitting and just that they be recompensed appropriately for these toils. Note, sir, that should you successfully smash ants, save a brother knight from peril, or extract a captured merchant from the hands of cutthroats, come see me. You shall be rewarded.
it. Oh, speaking of payment, my clerks have brought word of heroic deeds on your part. Please accept this compensation for your toil, good sir.
Well, I just wandered into money that I didn't know was here.
Can't help but be curious, but where do the funds for those payments come from?
The Ducal Treasury, of course. Her illustrious Highness Anna Henrietta assigns great value to bravery and selfless patriotism. It is her standing order that any knight may receive a wage. Pardon me. Financial compensation for his dedication to defending the duchy's internal security and order.
Wouldn't mind a glance at your books. Ones you're willing to sell, that is.
They do anything interesting? So he pays wage around here. Oop. Lot of recipes, it looks like. Of varying costs. Some of them get a little up there, don't they? Yeah, they do. So he's got sign intensity recipes and stuff like that. And he's got some basic alchemy ingredients and a whole lot of books. All right. Let's go all in. It's a low enough sum.
Wouldn't happen to play Gwent, would you?
Everyone just nodded silently. Alright, we're kind of low on specials right now. Specials the wrong word. We're low on, well, pretty much the hero cards, I suppose. We'll just see how it goes. Fun little experimental chance. Alright, doesn't matter. I was about to say I should have checked to see if I could have picked a different hero, but I guess the hero doesn't matter if he's canceling my hero ability. We have Scorch, we have Mandrome, something that where all it does is transform Berserkers, so do I have a Berserker is the question? The answer is currently no. I got two of these Type Bond characters, got both of these identical Muster characters, so get rid of one of you. Hey, Sirius here. I'll get rid of Mandrome. I didn't draw a Berserker, so it's not going to do anything. And I don't have any spies either, so I gotta make do with what I got right now. Alright. Huh. Could just go in heavy off the bat and just see how things go. Yeah, let's make him spend some cards. So it can confirm it only brings in the other light longship and nothing else. He's playing the elf immediately, which I can't do anything about. All right, I'm gonna pass. He's gonna get a card advantage from the elf. Let's make him play cards to get this advantage. Damn, right, Nilfgaard has 10. Nilfgaard has non-hero 10s in its deck. That's scary. I'm not used to having no spies at all. Alright. These are so weak! They're all fours! They are all fours. And he just put down 20. Wow. Nilfgaard has a 10 that revives other units, so he just brought in two 10s. Okay. Okay. I'll go in weak. Let's let him place a bunch of cards for a while. He's passed already. Interesting. Okay. Didn't really count for that. So he wants to get the card advantage on me right now. That's what he's hoping for. Well, it would take a lot of cards to take out his 10, so it's tempting to scorch it. But I'm just concerned that his hand might have a bunch of other really powerful cards waiting in it. So maybe I should save the scorch for later. Because I could open next round by playing these specials first. I don't really have much to offer right now, do I? This is a terrible deck. Alright, I don't wanna blow through all my specials necessarily. Let's try Siri. And then a weaker card to round it out. It's one victory for me for what little it really offers me. Alright. Skellige ability triggered. What is the Skellige ability? I actually don't know. It made these characters show up? Are they from my graveyard? No, they're not. But one of them might be. I'm not really sure. I should look up what the Skellige ability is. Alright, we'll find that out later, I suppose. I should have checked that immediately to find out what it was. Well, that gives me a chance. That might make everything make more sense. Maybe low-value cards come back into the field after rounds happen. I'm noticing they're both four. Maybe there's a special quality to having level four items on the field. I'm going to try to keep my units weak for now, just so I can scorch his 10 as my last action. Or second to last action, because of the muster. And the tight bond bonus I'll be getting. But I have nothing. I have no war horns, I have no decoys, I have no medics. There's very little going... There's very little keep me going right now. And he might even just scorch me. Yeah, it'd be reasonable to expect him to have it. Let's scorch his guy, and then just end the round and see how it plays out. I'm sure he'll beat me. Oh. Immediately. Well, so much for my tight bond. He scorched in turn, and now I'm over. So let's find out what his four cards are. Can he make up that gap of 22? He has another scorch. Alright. Level 3. Does he have a tight bond? He has a lot of tight bond characters to play, but does he have their matching pairs? Yes. Okay, it's getting very... Oh, I won! How did I win? We both drew terrible hands. Admittedly, he might have a terrible deck. So I got King Bran. There's a modifier. Let's find out what he does. Also, let's try to find out what this... Two random cards from the graveyard are placed on the battlefield at the start of the third round. Interesting. So Skellige gets a third round bonus where two cards at random from the graveyard are put there. Interesting. I wonder if that's absolutely any card. Because if you think about it, you can't have special effects affect stuff like Mysterious Elf, the special cards, I mean the hero cards. But could your racial ability affect it, I wonder? Anyway, where's King Bran? Don't see him, so he must be a leader card. He is a leader. He is a king, after all. There he is. Units only lose half their strength in bad weather conditions. Ooh. This one, shuffle all cards from each player's graveyard back into their decks. Also interesting. Why would I want that, though, if two random things from my graveyard are going to go back into my game? Oh! If I shuffled my graveyard back into my deck, then it would give you the ability to clear your graveyard so that you can make sure two specific characters go into your graveyard and are more likely to then be the characters that get drawn back to the field. It's a way to try to... That's interesting. That'll be interesting to try to employ tactically. Yeah, if you know certain things are going into your graveyard, using that ability might make things luck out for you. Alright. Skellige's interesting, if nothing else. So I can't even make this up right now. I look in here and... The first thing I see in my quest, or one of the first things left over in my side quest, basically the only thing left in Toussaint right now, that's just the Cover Bianco, and these are both Gwent quests, so this is the only normal quest left in my entire log for Toussaint, and it's go to the Duco Camerlengo. So I'm going to be turning right back around now to where I just was, because apparently he's surprisingly important. I was talking about doing main quest, but I might as well... This is too weird of a coincidence for me to not follow up on it. For those of you thinking this might be over soon, by the way, there's probably more quests to be had, because there's still notice boards floating out there I haven't visited yet. It's just a particular coincidence that I happen to have this as my last remaining quest, when I happen to do the Gwent thing and happen to wander over straight to this guy and then talk to him for a Gwent card, without even realizing he's the only remaining quest. Character in my log. That's great.
Greetings, knight. Much is said in Beauclair of your bravery and dedication. That's your security claim to compensation. Sign here, please.
Can't help but be curious, but where do the funds for those payments come from?
The Ducal Treasury, of course. Her illustrious highness, Anna Henrietta, assigns great value to bravery and selfless patriotism. It is her standing order.
We just had this exact dialogue.
Well, see you later.
Am I missing something?
For a night.
Whoa! Okay. I think it just failed to trigger last time? What's the detail here? So this is actually also not a normal quest. It's also a weird, like, region-wide thing. Complete the contracts you took on from the Camerlingo. When did I take on contracts? Because that was just the same dialogue as before where they just explain where the money comes from. Which she already did. Let's see, altogether typical looking notice, looking for strongmen. That's no information there. Okay. Are they just all over the... I believe they're all over the map. Okay. So this is just a huge region-wide thing. I've done 3 out of 15 already. And so there's just a series of locations where something's going wrong. Okay, good to know. They're like the equivalent of those... Well, these, really. They're just all the undiscovered locations and point of interest that normally dot the map. But now a bunch of them are marked as being from a specific quest. I'm sure they involve taking over Hans's, saving merchants, and that basic stuff. I took over Hans over the last few episodes, and I've saved a few merchants over the course of doing the vineyard quests. All right. So, that's what we're down to. We're down to 2 quests that involve wandering around and just clearing the map like a Ubisoft game. So not the highest priority for me. Let's get on to the main story, which I've neglected for a few episodes. So our goal is to meet Damien at Count Delacroix's mill after midnight. And, time limit's on, actually, because it's getting close to midnight right now. Let's just head on over. Oops. It's funny, I'm hitting the point now where... Oh, crap, this is a terrible route for a horse.
Let's go.
I'm hitting the point now in the game where I get oddly nostalgic about the earlier episodes. It's something it's a specific emotion that only really comes up when I play long Western RPGs that have tons of story and side quests and stuff. Witcher does it the most of all, where the sheer scale of it baffles me sometimes, so we get to this point in the game and I think, like, wow, remember when we were, like, doing a tournament so that we could secretly find out what curse was ailing some, star-crossed lover, or we, remember when that, I think it was a cyclops or a giant destroyed a windmill, and then when we first got here, and, like, there's so many things, I'm like, well, that was a long-ass time, whoa. What was that warning for? Oh, I didn't see what the warning was for. I was already running.
Not so fast, Roach.
Oh, was that a... That seemed important. What was the warning for? Well, I believe this warrants a change of plans. Warning, you are nearing a turning point in the story. After this, you will no longer be able to finish certain side quests. Save your game before continuing. So I think we might be putting the main story on hold for now until I finish basically every side quest. I don't think there's actually that many left in this expansion. And I would like to fully wrap up this expansion before I finish the story, because then I can kind of put a nice bow on this whole part of the game. And then at that point, we'll probably take a break from the game, but at some point I do still plan on coming back and spending even more time doing side quests from the main game, because I think there's still more. At some point, I need to make like a giant spreadsheet of all the quests I've completed and all the quests in the game and try to compare the two lists to figure out what the hell is left, because it's a big game, but I'd like to see it all. But don't think we're going to be capturing the castle quite yet. What happens if I cancel? It says okay and cancel, but what the hell's the difference? In both cases, the message is just going to go away and like... They don't have anything to do with it. There's a meaningless option. Now here's this looks like a location we haven't visited before. Big vertical wall. What do we have? Admittedly, very hard to see anything right now. Maybe we could skip to morning. Just a few more hours. It looks like a very vertical area, which of course means a lot of shadows right now. Ooh, corpse. Wasn't expecting that. That's a dead cow. Why is dead cow? Those bats are birds. Definitely a cluster of them up there. Yeah, it's a town built under a cliff face. So they have scaffolding just to get back up there. Not getting a lot of evidence of humans so far. Oh, there's one.
What the hell happened here?
What did happen here? Huh? Any answers? Hmm? Yeah, he's not one for talking. Hey, is he? Wait, is that an enemy down there? Ooh, that's not good. I should probably take care of that. Witcher or not, you're still to bust your bum. You shut your mouth, random asshole. I'm about to kill horrible corpse monsters downstairs. What are they? Ugh.
That stench.
They are nasty out in the light. Hey there. Is that an owl down there? Oh, hello. Hey! Sure is. He just barely got around the attack. Are they healing? Oh, right, they heal over time, don't they? Just be careful. Nope. Not the safest situation to attack because they're all grouping up. Not the best opportunity to try to stock up on I would like to be able to stock up on charges on my weapon to make it more powerful permanently. This bastard reflects damage, though. This guy, though, doesn't seem to be very receptive to anything around him. How you doing? Hanging out? Being on fire? Having a good time? He's trying to counter. Not really counter, but just hit me in my attack. I'm trying to charge up my weapon if I can. I don't think I'm gonna make it to 10 on this guy. Nope, 9. And so we stop. There's a few things at least. For the sake of our stuff.
Murderous Vandegildes.
Sure, why not? That's a very dead cow. That's a cow on top of a human. That's all the more concerning. What?
Need to ask around. Locals might know something more.
Bovine blues. Alright. That'll get us started. So there's a cow on top of a human and also gutted. So the cow was probably killed and thrown on top of the person. Cows, even if a cow just fell on a... Yeah, they wouldn't just fall over on them. Even, although a ghoul could have... In a freak accident, a ghoul could have gutted the cow and the cow could have fallen over on the humans, but... They're necrophages. They're probably here because of the corpses, and they probably didn't cause them. And this seems to be something important here. Contract. Mysterious plummeting cattle. Okay, that seems directly related to me. Urgently needed. Specialist used to the strange and extraordinary. Must be fast and reliable. Sorcerer, druid, or witcher preferred. Problem involves cattle. Falling out of the sky at night and must be cleared up fast. Work must resume at quarry soon, as we're up against tight deadlines. For details, see Foreman of Ardaizo Quarry. That's gonna be interesting to follow up on. The reign of terror of Filbert Fourfingers and his dogs is over. We have good news for you, dear subscribers. Filbert Fourfingers is dead. The vicious Hans of Mount Crane has been defeated by the famed Witcher Geralt of Rivia, and the castle handed over to the guard. We must ask, however, why a foreigner had to clean this mess up for us. Where are knights errant when we need them? So the notice board's actually reflecting actions that I've taken. Knightly expedition to Castle Dacia, or Dacia. As all know, ever since that villainous Filbert Fourfingers and his hunts murdered the family managing Castle Dacia estate, vileness has gone afoot there. There are even whispers the dreaded exterminator has made it his home. The time has come to investigate those claims. I'm gathering brave souls willing to join my expedition. Henkel the Bearded, Knight Errant. So it sounds like that's probably another Hans that I could help out with. This one in particular seems to be... It looks like Fourfingers would have wiped out the people that lived there. Because we read from Fourfingers' notes that he has like an old grudge against them. So the estate got cleared out and it sounds like another rival enemy may have made that their new base. Political philosopher seeks succor. looking for a suitable location to deliver a speech entitled The Beast as a Metaphor of Monarchy. Sure. Forest lovers, beware. Remember the days when we would pick berries and mushrooms in the Blesher Forest without a care in the world? Those happy times are gone, for wolves big as mules and fierce as if gripped by hydrophobia now prowl those woods. Every day there are fewer places where one can feel safe in our beautiful duchy. When will our duchess do something? I think that's going to be a monster den then. Birthday party invitation. All those who would like to have a drink with me are invited to join me at the Cockatrice on the 18th day of this month. The day will mark 40 years since I first stepped a foot into this world. Mind that neither food nor drinks are on me. I will accept gifts, though. Victor, you know which one. Victor, the one who doesn't pay for anything, apparently. I'm sure they'll be happy to hear about that. So, yeah, mysterious plummeting cattle. I'm sure we'll be following up on that. We seem to already have two quests related to cattle, Bovine Blues and Mysterious Fallen Cattle. Unless it's just the same quest. We'll see. That might have just been the quest prompt for what I'm doing right now. Just coincidentally hung in the same location. Oh, don't want to fall. Paused for a second there because I thought I might be walking towards a cliff. That is a hand. It's a very large hand. So this is all a quarry. You can tell because it's all dug down. You can see individual shelves everywhere and all the scaffoldings here. This is the kind of place that I could have potentially ended up working at and still might one day for all I know. Options. Hey, a blacksmith. Don't always find more of those. So, person I'm looking for is down there. Gotta find a way down that doesn't kill me. Here we go. In some games, you can make that jump, but in Witcher, no. You'd be very dead, very fast.
What the golly blasting devils are you doing, men? What plague? An unfortunate turn of events, that's all. Get back to chiseling. If we don't deliver that head on time, the infestor will twist my plums off.
Is that what you'll tell Emil's widow? That a cow crushed him and it was an accident? This, sir, is a grave matter. It requires a specialist, some mage or warlock.
What happened here?
Look, it's that witcher who's come to town. Maybe he can do something, an exorcism or the like. We should ask how much coin he'll want.
Saw your notice. Got a problem with... a cow? Fear a plague, is that it?
Yes, indeed, and a horrid one at that. We've irked the gods something true we have. In Zerikania, they've sent a plague of locusts, then of frogs. With us, they skipped right to raining cows town on us.
Enough! Enough! No need to sow panic. Come, Master Witcher, I shall divulge to you the matter at hand. Yes, an unfortunate matter indeed, to be crushed by a cow. A true shame, Emil. He was a good worker. I told them at once there had to be a simple explanation. But that lot, no, right away they started in screaming, plague! Demanding higher wages for hardship. Poor working conditions, you see? They'll ruin me, the blotters.
My job is to figure out why a cow fell from the sky, that it?
That too. The thing is, since none bother to clear the cow corpse, some filths overrun the other pit. We fear to venture there.
Not surprised. Cow, where'd it come from? What kind was it?
Why, the ordinary spotted kind. Nothing unusual. Its corpse rots in the other pit, sends out its stench, and Emil lies right beneath it. Will you tend to the matter and take on the contract?
What exactly is going on here?
Construction of a statue of the Prophet Lepiota. We're carving it. Not all at once, that is, but piece by piece. A pious infestus revived the project after years of neglect. He's engaged all nearby quarries in its completion. And we would be on schedule were it not for the incident. Please, Master, will you look into it?
Need to know more about this accident. Anyone actually see what happened?
No, but sounds there were. Osterv had just gone to see how Emil was getting along when suddenly we heard an ear-botching boom. Moments later, something smashed into one of the cranes.
Doubt it was the cow that hit the crane.
Probably true. At any rate, come morn, we ventured out to sea, but the vermin drove us off. With that, all work came to a halt. Has remained so since. Master, tarry no longer, please. Will you take on the matter?
Fine, I'll look into it. Might be a botched portal, but I doubt it.
Lepiota reward you with progeny aplenty. I shall keep an eye out for your return.
So he suggested it might be a botched portal. The idea of there being... I mean, how would a portal drop them out of the sky? I guess there'd have to be a sky portal somehow. Like a portal that somehow has the other end kicking them out in the wrong direction. And just out into random space instead of the intended location.
My head shakes so
what if there's just something really big? What if there's like a giant that just picks them up and throws them around? What if there's a catapult? Oh my god, did somebody make a catapult?